So what I want to do today is I want to encourage you. I want to encourage you to never, ever, ever stop. Never give up. Never stop fighting. The battle's going to wage on, always. Every day you're going to be faced with resistance and hurdles. But the question is, what are you going to do? What are you going to do about it, man? Fight. Don't ever give up, all right? Never give up and never back down. And in Jesus' mighty holy name, Proverbs 18:21, death and life are in the power of the tongue. Be careful what you're putting out there, all right? Be careful what you're talking about. Be careful about how you look at yourself. Because if you see yourself as someone who is incapable of doing things, certain things, or you got all these limitations and fears in your life, you are going to wreck yourself in the way you deal with life and the way you tackle problems. It will affect everything you do, the way you talk. God did not design you to be mediocre and live a mediocre life. The way God designed you is for you to excel. God wants you to always think big, and God gave you that ability, okay? We all have it. It's just that a lot of us, the majority of us, refuse to use those skills and talents for bigger things, for achieving things. This is the way God wants you to grow. God designed your life to excel like this, constantly. But a lot of us live like this, in a mediocre lifestyle, living limited. And many of us live like this. We live our lives on a decline like that. But this is how life is, though. Life is like this. Life is constantly up, down, up and down, up and down, just like that. You gotta figure out what to do when you're on a down slope. Because if you are constantly thinking down on yourself, and you're always telling yourself, man, I can't do this. I'm not that good. I'll never be able to achieve things. You just sabotage yourself, your life. Don't think like that, all right? Do not think like that. Here's the thing. Do not set yourself up for failure, okay? How do you do that? How does that happen? Easy. By speaking down on your life. By telling yourself you can't achieve things. By telling yourself you're not capable of doing things. Don't think down on your life. You got to constantly be thinking about excelling in life. Every single day. Every single hour, every single minute of the day, every single second. Never sit there and never ever accept mediocrity, man. Never. You are more than that. The Bible says you are more than a conqueror through Jesus Christ. And your ability to do things is just, man, mind-blowing. You can do so much. Another thing too, stay away from the alcohol. Don't let that stuff fool you, man. You're chasing something that you can't get no more. The party, the drugs, the alcohol, all the stuff you're doing to try to bring the party back, it's not gonna happen. You're trying to fill a void inside your heart that only God can fill. When God created you, He created you so that you can have Him here in your heart, all right? And nothing else can take the place of God. Absolutely nothing else. There is no drug. There's no alcohol, there's no pill, there's no idol or anything that could take the place of Jesus Christ. Remember that. A lot of you are still chasing that high that you had way back in the days. You're not going to find it, man. You're not going to find it. The party was over a long time ago. I stopped drinking in 2013, okay? But the party was over in the 90s. You know what I'm saying? But I stayed stuck. I continued to drink year after year after year. And I lost so much, man. I lost a lot. Don't let nothing in your heart that's going to keep you captive and living in sin constantly. Whether it's your secret sins or whatever. Okay? Stay solid. Stay firm. Make a commitment to get closer to God if you don't know God. And if you're like the prodigal son and you're distant from God and you're running away, from God, God never left you. God never ever left you. You left God. And if you don't know the Lord, let me tell you this right here. Now God, that's where evil creeps in. Then the evil is going to keep you in bondage. I'm not playing, man. the evil is going to have you consumed. And there's no way you're going to be able to break that bondage unless you give it up to Jesus Christ. Okay? Because without God, that's where evil steps in. And then the devil will wreak havoc on your life. Yes, I said the devil. The devil's job is to kill, steal, and destroy. And he's going to take you out. As long as you're not in Christ and you're not committed, the devil's going to wipe you out, straight up. And his goal is to get you to die outside the will of God. So, you have the choice. Are you going to let all that atheism eat you alive? And all that pride eat you alive? And all that raw living? Today I just saw a youngster right up the street from here. He had a shirt that said, F God, think of yourself. It's the same thing as a Satanist views. Do what thou will shall be the whole of the law. That's in the book of the law. Satanist stuff. But that's pride, man. That's exactly what the devil wants you to do. He wants you to live your life your way so that you can be selfish and full of pride and live a humanistic life. That way when you die in sin. And when you stand before God, you might think right now that there's no such thing as a moral absolute. There's no moral accountability for your life. That's a lie from the pit. Moral accountability is when you stand before God, and you will. Yes, you will. One day you are going to stand before God and be judged. When you stand before God, you're going to be held accountable. The Bible says your soul is required of you. That means that when you, whatever you think, whatever opinions you have developed, and perceptions that you have come up with in life, if it's outside the will of God, and you're chasing stuff that God don't want you chasing, you worship sports, cars, drugs, women, sex, you know what I'm saying? Outside the will of God, straight up. So when you're living in a humanistic lifestyle like that, you are automatically outside the will of God. And when you stand before God on your day, remember, your day is coming. You're either going to hear one of these two things. God is either going to say, depart from me, he that worketh iniquity, I never knew you. That means that you were living outside of God's will. You thought you was all right. You thought you was doing things that pleased God. You was pleasing man or whatever. But you had it wrong. You had it twisted. Because you can't mix the world with Christ. I'm talking about ungodly things. Okay? You're either going to hear that, or you're going to hear, well done. That means that you stuck it out, man. You held your ground and you stood firm on your faith. And that's what faith is, living for Christ. Once you believe in God, once you put your faith in God, all your faith 100% in Christ, God will begin to show you. And you ask him with sincerity, he'll begin to show you things. And he'll begin to release things in your life that are dangerous for you. And sometimes it's sin, man, it's holding us back, it's hurting us. One more thing, you don't got no reason to give up. You don't have any excuse to give up. There is no excuse, there is no valid excuse as to why you should give up. You better not ever, ever, ever give up. In Jesus' mighty holy name, stay bold, stay confident, stay courageous, and keep on smashing on it. Now get out there and go get it.